We've got 1:13 left in the first half of this one. Nice D from Vucevic. And here's MP from outside. And again for three. Man, he's really launching them from outside the arc.
Man, so locked in. Feeling confident in his three-point shot tonight.
Rose, the pass to Barrett. Back to Rose. And there's the drive. Count it. And that shot gets him in the books. He's 1 for 3.
And their offense seems to be coming around. Now they're shooting upwards of 50% from the field.
The three ball. And MP with a basket on the assist by Ball. MP's got 45 points.
You want to know why they're winning? It's because of his play offensively.
43 seconds left in the second. Here's Barrett. He's been a big scorer for this offense, averaging around 20 points a game. Oh, and he brings it down with a two-handed jam.
Throws it down emphatically.
He's got serious hops, right? You add that to his ability to penetrate, that's two easy points. Knocks down the triple. MP's got 12 points now in the quarter.
He's dropping the three ball with incredible consistency. What a barrage here in the first half.
We've got 22 seconds left in the second period. Barrett against Lamb. Outside Barrett. Over Lamb. Offline from the top of the key.
I don't know if he got in his own head there or what, but the defense can't really take credit for that miss.
So as we conclude the first half, a fairly one-sided game. It's the Bulls running away with it. And we'll see you back here after the break. Third quarter action in just a bit.
Hey folks, happy you joined us. The action tonight, a bit wild and a big deficit now for the New York Knicks.
Definitely they need to get out on the three-point shooters and contest. The deep ball is killing them. This is what happens when the other team identifies your weakness and just keeps hammering on it.
And moving on, let's take a peek at how the East is shaping up here in the midseason.
Well, I think for the Knicks, I guess they're playing decent, remaining somewhat competitive. Just feel like this team is stuck right now, unable to get to the next level, searching for the answers.
And that's it for halftime. Thank you for joining us. We send you back to Brian Anderson for the start of the third quarter.
Gap on the scoreboard. The second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. Hey, you look at MP in this game. He's been everywhere.
He's hit shot after shot from deep. He's so locked in right now.
If I'm his teammate, I keep feeding the hot hand, especially since he's been on fire from deep also.
And on the floor for Tom Thibodeau as we get into the second half. At forward, it's Barrett and Randall. Then there's Mitchell Robinson. Then there's Jalen Brunson, and it's Grimes in at the shooting guard position. And Jalen Brunson, he's a great option on the floor, Grant.
Yes, he is. can attack from different levels of the floor, solid shooting threat from outside, and gives you another playmaker to initiate the offense.
A moment to hear from Ali LaForce.
Thanks so much, Brian. Well, the Knicks trying to find their way back to the playoffs. Coach Tom Thibodeau said, you can't look backwards and you can't look too far down the road. You just have to take a look at today, lock into what we have to do, and focus on how we can be better. Back to you.
No shortcuts to greatness, Ali. Thanks for that.
And this is how he shines. He's a big part of their floor spacing.
Yeah, you got to know where he is at all times, especially when he's roaming around the perimeter ready to fire.
Now here's Barrett. 6 points for him. Randle, a screen on Levine. Barrett passes to Randle. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Randle's got 11.
We've seen that more than once today. An effortless basket inside.
MP outside. Puts up a three. Oh, another one falls.
And this game has his name written all over it.
He has been phenomenal. An offensive onslaught. For New York, they've gone just 1 of 3 in the second half. Randle inside, defended by DeRozan. For three, Barrett. Kept alive, tries again, and it's laid in by Randle. Randle's gotten 4 this quarter.
They have no answer defensively inside.
And they double up MP. And we're going to have a jump ball. Vucevic, the pass to MP. MP is doubled. Jacks up a three. Again! What an avalanche! 60 points. This guy can't be stopped right now.
They've had no answer for him in this one.
DeRozan against Randle. That shot off the mark. Oh, some solid D from DeRozan. From deep, MP. It's hauled in by Robinson.
And that's their first miss after hitting 4 in a row to start the half.
Down low. And it's Randle with the jam.
And every season, Randle seems to shoulder more of the offensive load. It's what allows him to dominate sometimes.
From deep, MP. Yes, sir. And it's Ball with the assist that time. Ball's got 8 assists here tonight.
The defense is nowhere to be found guarding the 3-point shot.
Well, we're into the third quarter, just over 2.5 minutes played. Outside Brunson. Randle against DeRozan. Randle can't hit. The Bulls have got 5 of 6 shots to fall so far in the third.
2 minutes.
And here's MP from outside. Nails it from beyond the arc. MP's got 18 points now here in the second half.
This is what it's been since halftime. Remarkable results from downtown.
In the modern NBA, you have to hit threes to win games, and they've made that adjustment since the break.
Now here's Randle. 15 points in the game. Good work defensively by DeRozan.
They really have a commanding lead, not just in points, but in...
Good! Another from three.
All game long. The threes have been pouring in for him. There is nothing stopping his shot.
And you know, this is already a game he'll never forget. He's trying to make it a game the world never forgets. Brunson. And again, the Knicks missing for Chicago. They've gotten 7 of 8 shots to fall in the third quarter so far. Pass to MP. The three. And again for three.
The parade of threes has no end in sight. He just keeps knocking them down.
And that latest triple ties him for second for most threes in a game. What a monster performance from deep it's been. Randle can't hit.
It hasn't been his best quarter. I mean, he's trying to shoot himself out of the slump.
From deep, MP. Randle pulls down the board. New York has gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the third. Outside Barrett. They need this. And it's cleared by Vucevic. Vucevic has got his 7th rebound here tonight.
Okay, now I think he's starting to get in his own head right now. Maybe he's overthinking things a little bit, and as a result, he's just been off.
He drops yet another dime, just facilitating this offense like a maestro.
And the Knicks shooting a solid 47%. Things just don't seem to be clicking for them offensively.
Yeah, they really need to find a way to get back on track.
6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. For three, Randle. And it's cleared by Vucevic. Vucevic has got rebound number 8 here already in the game. From deep. Connects again from distance.
And of course it falls for him. And that three pushing him into the record books.
He is now tied for the most threes in a game. An incredible shooting night for him on a night we'll never forget.
Terrific defense by
the Bulls. The Bulls, 101. The Knicks, 48.
From these teams.
At the line for the Bulls,
you got this, MP.
Javonte Green. At the line for one,
well, the NBA has gotten tougher on flagrant fouls. But you see instances where guys get hurt, they miss a lot of time, and yet there's only a one-game penalty for the fouler. Something to look at, you think, RJ, or not?
What if the flagrant?
Ayo Dosunmu. Third personal foul. 15 fouls.
Starting to embellish on their injury in order to make sure that other people get suspended. That's how petty our league is.
Dosunmu is out there with MP. Then it's Green. Then there's Jeremy. And again for three.
Unbelievable. Gets the record with a beautiful three.
A new single game record and a night that everyone will remember the rest of their lives. Timeout called. The Knicks. They trail. 1:06 left in the fourth. He's checked in for New York.
And let's face it, this one was never really in question. They came out with purpose and just overwhelmed the opposition. A great win for the Bulls.
Man, they were in a groove from long range tonight.
Yeah, they were able to find space, and they were ready to let it fly the moment they saw an opening.
And this will give them their 28th win of the year.
And they have to feel pretty good about themselves, taking the first two games of the season between these teams.
And as it was happening, as it was building, you knew this was a monster game for MP.
We certainly got to see his best effort on offense, attacking the defense without fear and grabbing a lot of buckets.
Well, Chicago's shooting 47% since the fourth quarter started. Three-pointer. Bulls keep it alive.
They grab the long rebound, resetting the shot clock.
And good! There's another!
Incredible! 81 on the night, channeling his inner Mamba right now.
There's no slowing this guy down. He's on fire. Right side, Brunson. Back to Toppin. Lets it go from deep. And it's Chicago with a board. MP outside. And yes, another basket.
That score moving him clear into third all time for scoring.
Well, you just knew it was a matter of time the way he's been playing. I'm sure he's not finished. Rose outside. So it's the Bulls winning this one easily. Showing that they're the far superior team. They win it going away.
I'll tell you what. give it up for their fans. They love to watch this team dominate. You best believe they're all going home happy tonight.
And that'll do it, folks. This is Brian Anderson saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
We'll see you next time.
Shot! Good ball, Betty.
They did an amazing job on your statue. It looks just like you.
Let's go!
Just like that.
Yes! Easy work. Thank you.
One more.
Yo, they not about to be ready.
Game last night.